Hey guys, G-Wizard here, along with
Dominic11121, but I'm not really called that anymore. I'm Chrisman Entertainment, so if you see me commenting on G-Wizard's videos, you know that's me.
So, we're about to play this strange game that I've never played ever for the Wii. Yes, we're playing another Wii game. Ah, you do need the nunchuck for this, okay. I'm gonna plug it in first. There we go. Nunchuck's plugged in, licensed by Nintendo. Of course, the licensed M&M's product. What do you expect from this? Zoo. Never heard of that company. Nikitoba Games. Never heard of that company either. So here's the title screen. Right? Looks normal. Oh, come on, now it's gonna run. What a tease. Okay, I'll wait.
They put you through so many screens before the loading screen. It's like, you'd think that it would be loaded by now.
Finally! Took forever. So, yeah.
Is that Comic Sans?
Actually, it is Comic Sans. Jeez, what? Oh, are they on a tight budget here? Let me turn it up a little. Right. So, let's go to new game. No, I don't want options. New game. There we go. It's gotta load again, really? Jeez.
It's gonna load the really horrible cutscenes.
And I'm loading it off a USB stick, by the way, so. Please don't take as long as Sonic 06 or Sly Cooper Thieves in Time. There it goes. Dominic, I think I need to get my eyes checked. Is this for the Wii or is this for the N64?
It looks like it's from the N64, but it's from the Wii.
I just wanted to make sure of that.
A lot of third-party games on the Wii aren't even good, and this one is so bad. It's less than third-party, in my opinion.
I could tell this is a budget game, because the mouths don't even sync. And I just love that, Christmas tree. That Christmas tree looked like it come from an Atari Jaguar game.
This is a very intense cutscene.
I don't know, but what year did this come out?
I don't know. I'll look it up.
Okay. Oh my god, how long did this cutscene even skip it?
November 13, 2008.
2008?
Yeah.
So, this is older than Sin and Punishment Star Successor. Sin and Punishment Star Successor is a better game than this and has better graphics and has a better frame rate than this crappy third-party shit fest that somehow came out on the same year as Super Smash Bros. Brawl and it's missing periods. Cool, when you collect $100, you'll get an extra life. I wish getting extra lives was that easy in real life. Yeah, the movement is kind of unorthodox. It's kind of like Sonic 4, where you're slow to start up, no matter how hard you push the D-pad. Alright, ouch, don't worry. Alright, so you get health power-ups ripped straight out of Sly Cooper.
Is this like a Mario 64 health system?
Now it's ripping off Crash Bandicoot. We jump on boxes. That's better. Did they even spell check this? It's missing periods, and they lack proper capitalization. Oh my god. Fantastic, a candy. Pick it up quick. Yay. I got a candy. Let me eat it. Blue M button over there to save your progress. Alright, save point, basically. Safe and sound. There's no save indicator. Do they mean a checkpoint, not a save point?
They put a period.
There's no period at the end of the sentence, Dominic.
There's one of them that had a period. Right. So I give a slow clap to the developers of this game.
I'm holding controllers with both hands, so I cannot clap. Alright, go. There we go.
So did the candies just give you a bonus at the end of a level?
I think so. I think they only gave me like 5 points.
Wait, does this game only have 6 levels?
It's listing a lot of levels, but I think it's loading, but I'm not quite sure.
Looks like it's loading.
Or, it doesn't say it's loading, what the hell? Wrong. There it goes. Jesus Christ. Level 19? Is this like Bubsy 3D, where you gotta get all the rockets?
Or it could be like something similar to Star Coins in the Mario games.
Yeah.
This looks like Mario 64. Like, the mechanics are very similar to Mario 64.
I mean, no, this is not Mario 64. Mario 64 is better than this. Hell, the DS remake is better than this. I mean, at least you could control the camera, unlike in Ninja Bread Man, and if you press the C button on the nunchuck, you can bring it behind you, which is alright. So I'll give it the benefit of the doubt that it has better camera. Oh, come on, bullshit. I could have made that jump.
And when we Google search, what is the worst Wii game?
The worst Wii game would easily be Ninja Bread Man. I mean, I think I gotta search all the candies.
Okay, I'm reading one that's by Game Rant on GameRant.com, by the way. Okay. Just want to give credit to them.
Oh, no,
number 10,
no.
My aquarium.
Look, they have M&M doors. It's ripping off Super Mario 64, you were right. But there's
game
a door
party
over there.
Balls of Fury. Anything Pets with a Z. Anubis 2.
So this game is pretty much the platformer version of Pokemon Shuffle. It rips off mechanics from other popular games. We got stuff ripped off from Sly Cooper, we got stuff ripped off from Super Mario 64, from Crash Bandicoot. You get the point. This is Pokemon Shuffle if it were a platformer, and without forced microtransaction bullshit.
Number 5 is Alvin and the Chipmunks.
What?
Alvin and the Chipmunks is is the 5th worst Wii game according to Game Rant.
I do not know where to go. Do we have to get all the candies? I mean, there we go. Alright, so.
You have to collect all 120 candies to beat the game.
Yeah, but I'm trying to find an M&M store. We have to get that. Oh, I'm stuck! God, why did I get stuck? That does not happen in Mario 64. Okay.
Wait, how many FPS do you think that you're getting?
FPS? You mean the frames?
Yeah,
30. I'd say 30. This game runs worse than Sin and Punishment Star Successor. And now we're going to the next stage, huh?
Wait, does a 3 mean that there's 3 candies there?
Probably. And yeah, the game still has long loading times. Even though I load it from a freaking USB stick. Somehow it was actually somewhat quick this time. And oh my god, so much M&Ms. Oh wait, those are coins. My eyes deceive me. The heck? Okay, so you had to hold A to fly. I cannot guess which mechanic this is ripping off from, so I'll give him a point for a little originality. So goes.
This seems quite tedious.
Well, that was a short segment. Next level. Wait, what? We're back at M&M's HQ. Probably got a go to the new door, since we collected some of the candies.
That's probably the hub.
That means you gotta sit through shitty loading times. Finally. Candy collection duty. The hell is
Nintendo
it?
Nintendo actually has a page for M&M's Adventure.
Really?
Publisher Zoo Games.
What's that door over there? 60. And I don't need one more to get 10.
Play as one of your three favorite M&M colorful characters, red, yellow, and green. Each character has their own special abilities, essential to use them all to collect the hidden candies. Explore 6 different adventure-themed dimensions of the factory, including
the Valentine's.
What's the point
of this area? This is a dead end, or is that the area I started from? No? Let's see what's down here. Did I visit here? No, I didn't. There are coins. Lead to a new area, probably.
I completely forgot the story.
Damn it, you gotta play as green. And you gotta play as yellow. Wait. One is to pause? Seriously? I do not comprehend this game's shit. The one button is to pause.
It's usually the plus button.
I mean, look how far the one button is compared to the plus button. My finger sits on the hell?
Yeah, you beat the level.
Oh, great, I unlocked the zone. So I had to redeem all my M&Ms at the gumball machine. Couldn't I just go to there like Mario 64?
That'd be a lot easier.
Yeah, this game is both a shameful ripoff and a more truncated version of Mario 64. Alright, so we're going to the next level, finally. Valentine's Sector. I forgot that it was several months past February. I'm too late in playing this game.
And there's also a Halloween theme room. And then there's unique bosses at the end of each level.
Yeah, I bet those unique bosses are piss easy.
They're probably ripoffs of other bosses from other 3D video games.
And it's gotta load. Come on, load! My god.
You know, whenever you're playing Smash Bros, Smash 4, it's worth the loading time. Because you know you're gonna play a great game. But we already know that this is a terrible game.
Yeah,
why would you wanna wait for this?
I mean, think of it. This game looks worse than Super Smash Bros. Brawl, which came out the same year. It runs at half the speed Brawl does, and it rips off other puzzle mechanics before Pokemon Shuffle even did so.
Yeah, but we first party games, they usually run better and have better graphics. Like Super Mario Galaxy, for instance, that looked very, very polished.
Yeah, it looked really nice.
And that came out in like 2007.
Yeah, Mario Galaxy came out in 2007. Look at this, a stupid conveyor belt. You have to keep jumping, it's so tedious and stupid. Keep mashing that A button. No, I do not want to do this. I do not want to mash my A button like I did in Universal Theme Park Adventure. Shit. Come on.
You almost have an extra life.
I just realized that. I have 95 coins. The B button does nothing. I just realized.
Maybe it'll do something in the future.
You jump on enemies, and The hell? It only stuns enemies for a brief moment. I mean...
Wait, is that like that one guy from Mario 64 that throws you?
Yeah. This is totally a Mario 64 ripoff. Wait, let's see if that guy can throw me. Let's see. No, it just took off half my health! You lied to me! What is wrong with you, Dominic? You lied to me!
I honestly didn't know that. I thought it would be like those guys from Mario 64 in that tic-tac clock that would throw you if you stood on them. Yeah. I guess that they made it damage you just so it wouldn't be a complete ripoff.
They didn't do it to be a complete ripoff, they do it to trick you.
So those safe points are basically checkpoints, I think.
Yeah, they are checkpoints, but instead they wrote them as save points, again, to trick you. And their script is terrible. They don't even put periods properly, and they don't capitalize stuff properly. No thought went into the script.
Yeah.
And it isn't even hilariously funny either, like Dimpleman 3 goes, "Hey! Stop it! Stop with the freaking thing."
And they made a lot of stupid choices, kind of like using Comic Sans, not having anybody proofread the actual script.
Yeah, you
can, that appears on screen.
You could just tell that this is a low budget game done extremely poorly. But imagine the look on my face when I will probably play Eminem's Kart Racing in the future.
One very bad thing that you can do in level design for a lot of games like this is making you go through the same shit over and over.
You know, right? How do you get out of this level? I do not know. I cannot find the end of the level.
Pause it by pressing the 1 button and seeing if there's an exit level button if you don't want to play this.
In progress.
Oh, those are like the sectors you unlocked, I think.
Speaking of which, why is there no map? There is no freaking map. Like, this is a confusing level layout. You don't even know where you're supposed to go. You have to pick green for there. And, you know, I circled around this level one too many times, and I cannot get to the end of the level. I just noticed right there. Did I go in there already?
I'm starting to believe that this level this game is hated by a lot of people because
of the level
design.
Oh my god, look at this, the box blew up when you jumped on it. That is totally not a Crash Bandicoot ripoff. They had no creativity in this. They had absolutely no creativity. I mean, just think about it. When Genius Sinorni made Pokemon Shuffle, they looked up to Zoo as their role model. They wanted to be inspired by Eminem's Adventure to make Pokemon Shuffle rip off every puzzle game in existence, like Puyo Puyo, Bejeweled Blitz, Puzzle and Dragons, etc. But we're not talking about Shuffle, we're talking about this piece of trash, Eminem's Adventure. You just saw the camera spaz there? Good. Now I'm gonna jump on this box that says danger. You can't.
I would not.
You can't
buy any Eminem's games.
You can't fool anyone, Zoo. Hey, stop it. There's no way to attack other than jumping on him. I mean, if you have to obtain like a fuzzy creature like you do in Kid Cool, I will be so pissed if it's him. I don't have to step on this. Nothing. Wait, I didn't die yet? What? I think it'd take one more hit and then you die.
No, the power meter, like, wraps around the picture of red. Do you see it?
I found a secret? What secret?
What secret?
It doesn't even show you.
Why those coins?
Probably this one. This is the secret. It's not much. Yeah, this game sucks. oh look, I found the end of the level. Finally. How long has it been?
So hard because they didn't even try.
It's been 22 minutes, and I've been trying to find the end of this goddamn level. What is wrong with this game? Great, I gotta suffer through long loading times again.
Come fly with me. How about no?
Oh no, is this another flying level? Yes, it is. It's another flying level. We have to collect coins. At least there's no flying limit.
Yeah.
Still, this is tedious.
There's you know what this is ripping off? This is ripping off Flappy Bird.
Not even...
Hey, Preston, we have to press the same button
not even
to keep
close.
Flying upwards.
Not even close. There are no pipes to crash into. This is not a Flappy Bird ripoff. Besides, I played Flappy Bird. It's total insane. And is there anything beyond here? Nope, there isn't. Not that I can see because of the...
Is that the end of the level?
Because of the terrible fog that came out of an N64 game once again. And yes, this is the end of the level. That was tremendously short for some odd reason. There we go. Alright, next up is Tunnel of Love.
Oh, you missed an M&M.
Where'd you see an M&M? I didn't
miss... Because it has a 1 over it. That means you left one.
No, I collected it. I'm pretty sure I collected it. It was at the beginning of the level. Load already!
This is not worth my time.
Ditto. This game just sucks. They definitely took this game to the Shovelware Zoo. Okay. Oh, that's real nice. Be a jerk about the platform placement. That's fair. How am I supposed to jump on that? I have no clue. Maybe I have to jump up here. Yeah, there it goes. What? The game
just... I'm yawning because I'm tired. I'm tired of this game's bullshit.
I know. The game just tricked me into thinking that I think I just glitched through there. Right. Okay. Come on. Come on. Come on, Red M&M from an N64 game. You can get all the M&Ms. Shit. Well, I saved myself, but... Are there any M&Ms? There's one over there. Yes. High-speed platform jumping. Yes.
This is obviously not ripping off anything.
Yeah, I know, right? It's a totally original game that was totally not stolen from an older console. And then here.
I don't understand what that does. Is that just like a switch that triggers an event?
I think it's supposed to... Oh, I think that's the exit. No, it's just a... Wait. I'm playing as a red M&M. Why can't I access it?
Button.
You can jump using the Z button too? What is this? Wait. C button isn't working. I think they tricked the jump controls on me. It used to be C, now it's Z for some odd reason. I think the game bugged out. Oh no, wait, never mind. I derped. I meant to say Z was the jump button. God. This game is making me lose my IQ.
That's quite sad.
This game is making my IQ decrease worse than Pokemon Shuffle. They have done it. They have created the most tedious game in the universe. There's the door. Thank God that I won't get stuck again.
Or is this like some sort of a love factory?
Well, it is called the Tunnel of Love. I mean, Okay.
This kind of looks like a tunnel. Okay, now it looks like a tunnel.
Oh god, these guys again. God, stop it. Take me over there.
Why don't you want to go through the tunnel of love, Jesus?
I'm trying to go through there, but the game is being a total... Oh, wait, never mind. I could jump over it. I could jump over it.
I was gonna say...
I was gonna smack someone with this Wii remote, but nope. Another one. Alright.
But who would you smack?
Oh, no. A conveyor belt. These things take a million jumps to get past. And all this while you have to keep moving. It just tried to kill me. Hell no, there's no way I'm letting this game be the death of me.
If anybody 100% this game... Okay, two questions for you. How do you have the time to beat this game? Because this game, one, has long loading times, two, has very tedious conveyor belt mechanics.
What? You jinxed me! You said conveyor belt mechanics and look what happened! You know what?
But are you going backwards now?
No, there are coins that... Oh, come on, these guys are draining my health. That's not fair. Wait, maybe I am going backwards. What?
Yeah, you're going backwards.
I have to go up there.
You've been here, remember?
Yes. I had to go up there, apparently. But how can I go up there? Shit! That's some health. That's a miracle. Ow! I think I have to go to the conveyor belt on the far left. But that'll take forever. I don't want to do this. And there are enemies on my ass, which I can't kill. I can't even kill that thing by jumping on it. Maybe you can just walk on it. You could just walk over it. What? No. I'm not satisfied. I hate this game even more. I mean... I swear to God, if Genius and Artie creates a game like this, I will smack someone legit.
Smack them.
Jump over it. Yes.
That's what they deserve.
Another conveyor belt. Thank God it's one that moves forward this time, so...
I swear, if they make another pay to win, I'm going to lose my shit.
Another one. And I found an M&M. Alright. At least I know I'm on the right track. Oh no, another conveyor belt.
These take too long. The only reason why that they put these conveyor belts here...
I found the end of the level.
Finally. The only reason why that they make conveyor belts that go against you is just to make enemies. Just to make you vulnerable, right, so enemies can get to you.
Alright, this level should be short. There's only one M&M here. Yet it's taking freaking forever to load. Oh my god. This loading, man.
Do I really have to wait for this?
Yes, we both have to wait for this. This loading time takes as long as Sonic 06. Why is this game... Please don't tell me it crashed. Thank God it loaded. I was gonna turn the game off because I thought it crashed, then it loaded. Jump.
I would actually be quite relieved if you turned it off, to be honest.
Now I had to go through another one. Hopefully, this looks to be a lot more easier to go through than the other level.
This looks very annoying.
What do these hearts do? What are the purpose? And how can I not grapple them? There are more conveyor belts?
What the hell is going on with the camera there?
Why are there more conveyor belts? And they have TNT boxes! Screw this game.
Screw this, you... Zoo Studios or whatever they're called.
Ow, cut it out, stop it. Jump. Jump. Alright. There's an M&M right over there. Stop.
Okay. I think this game is even impossible with cheat codes.
I'm pretty sure there are people who managed to make game saves of it. So that way you can load the fucker with homebrew and then just get 100% with it. There's a save point. Is there a platform here? Can I go on it?
I'm going to go on YouTube.com and see if there is a, hang on.
Alright. Camera. There we go. Alright, so I can finally reach that M&M. Hey! Yes, I got it. I got the only M&M. Hey, just trying to look for the freaking exit. You don't have to hit me.
I'm gonna be right back for just a minute, alright?
Alright. So while Dominic goes to eat a whole bunch of M&Ms, I'm busy trying to find the exit in this godforsaken stage. Whoa! Another Mario ripoff enemy. And this thing's tossing TNTs like a madman. Oh my god. You know what, as soon as I beat the level, I am quitting this game. I had enough. If I can beat the level. There's the door over there. Yes, got through the door. And, thought I was gonna glitch through it. Alright, go here. Go here. Here. Jump. Don't you dare push me off, box. There's a door. I think that's the exit. Ah! Yay, I found the exit, finally. Jump in. There we go. Screw the Hall of Secrets. I want to get out of the game. I want to get out of the game. I want to get out of the game. Screw this. I'm done. I quit.
Are we going to the home menu?
I quit. I quit. This game sucks. M&M's adventure is terrible.
I'm going to go on YouTube and see if people actually played a full Let's Play of this.
So, in conclusion, M&M's adventure fails on so many levels, it is hard to believe.
I'm going to see if someone actually made... Okay, they made a lot of reviews, revisited reviews. So yeah, people have made... I think they have made full Let's Plays on this. So, I don't know who would have the time to actually complete this game, though. And if you want to actually play this game for the sake of, like, beating it and stuff, and not, like, for shits and giggles, well then, what kind of person are you?
So, in conclusion, this game is just so bad, it's hard to believe. I mean, this is the platformer version of Pokemon Shuffle, where it rips off so many good games, and they don't forgive him for it.
At least it doesn't have transactions.
Yeah, you're right. Then again, I downloaded this game for free off a website, so who am I to complain? The game's not even worth a penny. End of story.
True.
Bottom line, M&M's Adventure, stay away from the game. So yeah, this is G-Wizard End.
Dominic11121, or Chrisman Entertainment.